Students, the topic that we are going to cover today is I/O interface buses, USB, SCSI and PCI buses. Friends, we cannot connect the I/O devices directly to the CPU. That we have known and we have understood it in the last classes as well. Okay, there are so many reasons, maybe electrical reasons, maybe mechanical reasons, the devices has got different nature and the CPU has got different nature, and there are so many reasons that we have already discussed. Okay, today we are going to focus upon the buses which are there in the system. Okay, so on the basis of that, we have divided the buses, overall buses in the system, into three different categories. The first one is the bus which connect the CPU and the memory. This is the most prime quality or topmost bus inside the system, and this bus is called internal bus. Called internal bus and also known as processor bus. The bus which is connecting the processor and memory. Okay, so this is the first category. Second is expansion bus. Expansion buses are those buses which are connecting the motherboard and the slots for PCI and SCSI devices. Okay, those buses are responsible for connecting the devices to the motherboard. And then the third category of bus comes, that is the external bus. Okay, external bus, the bus which connect the actual devices to the system. Okay, so these are the three category of buses. So in this diagram you can see there are different buses. The first one is the processor bus. The processor bus is the bus which is connecting the memory and the processor. This is the fastest and synchronous bus which can allow the fast data transmission in between the processor and the memory. Okay, now we have got the second bus, that is PCI bus. It is also known as extension bus or expansion bus. Okay, this bus is connect the processor bus and the PCI bus. We can use a bridge interface is an interfacing circuit that can connect or allow the data transfer in between the two buses. Even though the PCI bus is also it is slower as compared to the processor bus, but it is also a synchronous bus. Okay, now to connect the other devices we need the expansion bus, that is the PCI bus. Okay, to PCI bus we can connect additional memory devices for additional memory in the system. We can connect the SCSI controller, SCSI controllers, through which we can connect the SCI bus. Okay, we have got Ethernet controller, Ethernet card or Ethernet connection is also connected with the help of PCI bus, and we can connect USB controller on the PCI bus, to which we can connect video devices, we can connect game devices. Okay, we connect ISA, that is Industrial Standard Architecture Interface, also to the PCI bus. Okay, and through this we can connect the IDE disk which can store the data. Okay, so SCSI bus, SCSI bus is also the one of the bus which is under the PCI bus. In this bus we can connect the disk controller, through which we can attach 1, 2 or some number of disk to store the data. SCSI bus is also useful for CD-ROM controller connection also. We can connect the CD-ROM controllers as well. Okay, so if we see from the point of view of data transmission and speed, so we will see that the speed of the processor bus is the fastest and it is synchronous. That is, the data transmission is a time signal based data transmission. Similarly, the PCI bus is slower as compared to the processor bus, but it is also synchronous. Okay, so these are the various buses, how these buses are connected to each other and how they are communicating. So basically, when we want to connect any device, we need to use expansion bus, and expansion bus support different controllers for different type of I/O devices, and we connect those I/O devices with the help of this bus. So the types of standard I/O interfaces we can divide into these three categories. The first one is the PCI bus, the second one is USB bus and third one is SCSI bus. Let's start with the first bus, PCI bus. The PCI bus, the full name of this bus is Peripheral Component Interconnect, and this bus has got the various facilities. It was developed in 1993 by Intel. It is the interface which is used to connect the processor and the chipset. Now, what is the meaning of chipset? Basically, chipset is nothing but those interfacing circuits which further connect the IO devices. Okay, those interfacing circuits which can further connect the IO devices. So, to the system bus or to the motherboard, this interface, this bus can be used to connect the chipset and the main bus, which can transfer the data to the CPU. Okay, this bus is faster than ISA. As we have discussed, industrial standard architecture bus, this bus is much faster than that particular bus. Okay, this is a synchronous bus. That is, the second bus is USB bus. The full form of it is Universal Serial Bus. And this bus we have seen in many devices. The device which has more USB port is better, or the it's a better market place, you can say, for that device is there. Okay, this was developed by a core group. The core group of companies has find that ki aaj ke samay mein bahut sari IO devices aa gayi hain, and many IO devices want to connect with the processor or with the system. ठीक है, बहुत सारी IO devices ऐसी आ गई थी जिनको कि हमें हमेशा उन devices को computer के साथ attach करना होता है, like fingerprint scanner, like mouse, like keyboard, okay, like digital camera and many more, flash drives. So to connect all those devices, industry ने ऐसा सोचा कि एक bus ऐसा होना चाहिए जिसमें हम easily plug और play easily कर सकें. Okay, so for that many big companies like IBM, Intel, Microsoft, okay, they come together, compact, और उन्होंने एक standard बनाया, that is called USB, okay, and USB derives, जो बड़ी companies थी, उन्होंने सभी ने अपनी devices में use किया, okay, it can connect up to 127 peripheral in a single USB, 127 peripherals हम attach कर सकते हैं, the maximum speed on which we can transfer the data by USB is 480 Mbps, megabytes per second. Maximum length of the cable in USB would be 5 meters, and if we use hubs, then it can reach up to 40 meters. It is a plug and play. It is well known. Everyone knows it. It is a plug and play type of bus, and it has, it use or it draw its own power. Iske paas apna khud ka power hota hai. आप किसी भी डिवाइस को यूएसबी से कनेक्ट करेंगे तो आपको उस डिवाइस को अलग से पावर देने की आवश्यकता नहीं है. ओके, इट कैन ड्रॉ इट्स ओन पावर, 5 वोल्ट्स एंड 500 मिली एम्पियर पावर ये जनरेट करती है. ऐसी डिवाइसेस जो इस पावर पे चलती हैं, उन्हें अलग से पावर की जरूरत नहीं रहती. वर्क्स ऑन द क्लॉक सिग्नल्स, इट डू नॉट नीड एनी टाइप ऑफ इंटरप्ट और हैंड शेकिंग सिग्नल्स. ओके, इट इज यूजिंग 64 बिट एड्रेसिंग. ओके, इट्स अ वाइड, इट्स विड्थ इज quite wide. It can transfer 64 bit of address, and that is why it can connect with different variety of IO devices. It operates with a frequency of 33 to 66 megahertz. Okay, and then last one is, it has a facility or feature of plug and play. We can connect any device anytime during the functioning, full functioning of computer, and we can use those devices easily. So this is PCI bus. The third standard bus is SCSI. It is known as Small Computer System Interface, SCSI. Okay, this device, this bus is used to connect SCSI devices. Those devices which are not synchronous devices and which do not share the clock with the CPU or the motherboard. Okay, with this bus we can connect 8 to 16 different devices at one time, and this bus needed handshaking between the devices when they want to interchange the data. Handshaking means it needs some interrupt signals to interchange or start the transmission of data. It means that this bus is not a synchronous bus with the CPU. So that's all from the buses. So thank you very much.